So now more on the schools. The Wall Street Journal notes that the recent increase in cases is driving tens of thousands of students back to virtual learning or pausing instruction altogether. The Journal reports, quote, since the school year kicked off, at least 1,000 schools across 31 states have closed because of COVID-19. The shutdowns are hitting classrooms especially hard in the Deep South, where most schools were among the first to open, a possible warning of what's to come as the rest of the nation's students start school this month. In Mississippi, nearly 14,000 students have tested positive for COVID-19 since the new academic year began in early August, sending more than 20,000 students into quarantine for each of the past 3 weeks. In New Mexico, around 1 in 10 school-aged kids tested positive for the virus when they're tested, double the rate of the adults. State data there also shows nearly 10% of the state's students have spent time in quarantine. And in Georgia, state officials say more than half of the state's recent outbreaks have been linked to schools. Meanwhile, new polling shows the majority of Americans support vaccine mandates in schools, but not for businesses. In the latest Washington Post ABC News poll, 59% say they are in favor of a mandate for teachers and other school staff, while 84% of Democrats and 60% of independents support it, 64% of Republicans oppose it. Republicans are also the outlier on vaccine requirements for eligible students, with 67% being against a mandate. Overall, though, 54% say they are in favor of requiring students to get vaccinated, and 52% say they support businesses requiring vaccinations for employees. That same poll shows vaccine hesitancy decreasing among younger Republicans and Republican-leaning independents. In April, 55% of Republican-leaning adults under 40 years old said they would probably or definitely not get vaccinated. In the latest Washington Post ABC News poll, that figure was at 36%. 48% of those under 40 years old also said they are at least partially vaccinated, and 11% said they are likely to get vaccinated. A lot of information, Joe, a lot of sort of storylines here that are frustrating, but there also is good news.
There is some good news. And Jonathan Lemire, I know the White House has to be looking at these numbers. In that same Washington Post story that I read that talked about all of these numbers, there was the focus on the fact that younger Republicans and Republican-leaning independents are becoming more open to taking the vaccine, are getting the vaccine, and also a pretty big number. I mean, there's been a jump from 67% of Americans being vaccinated in, I think it was May, to now 75% of Americans having at least one shot thus far. And if we can move that into the 80s, then some epidemiologists' predictions from over the weekend that we may be seeing the end of COVID in the fall may, in fact, come to pass.
Yeah, the White House won't quite go that far, as they tend to be conservative on most of their COVID projections. But there are some signs of hope here. You ran through the stats, but you know we are seeing a decrease in Delta cases in some of the states in the South and Midwest that were really the center of this current surge. Small drops, to be sure, but potential steps in the right direction. Seeing more people getting the vaccine, and polling suggests, indeed, particularly among the young, more of a willingness to consider getting those shots. That is all good news. But there are, of course, some dark clouds in the horizon, too. Dr. Gottlieb, who we have on the show all the time, was saying this weekend that he believes there'll be a jump in cases in the Northeast coming this fall because of the Delta variant, because of the return to schools, because of Labor Day travel. which is something that people are worried about throughout the country. There is talk of a new variant that is very, you know, to be sure, it's the early stages, more research needed, but it has shown some ability of getting around some of the antibodies produced by the vaccine. That, of course, would be worrisome. And then there's the confusion about boosters. Pfizer likely bringing theirs to fruition in just a few weeks, that third dose, but Moderna could be a few weeks after that. There's a little bit of delay per administration officials. So there would be, as a growing consensus, that a third shot is needed to protect against Delta, other variants. Not every American will be able to get one right away. So it's still sort of a mixed bag here, Joe. But yes, the overarching trend slightly towards positive, but certainly the White House and the officials that I talked to over the weekend still very preaching caution, saying we've got a long way to go.
Right. And just to underline what Dr. Gottlieb said, and boy, when he talks, I always listen because he's gotten it right more often than not. If you think back, we only have a year's worth of data to look at. But if you look back to last year and compare it to this year, you saw at least in the South the same trends. That when the weather started to heat up in the late spring and the summer, you started to see, as people in the South, in the Sun Belt went inside, into the air conditioning, you saw places like Arizona, Texas, and Florida, you saw their numbers spike. Last fall, as you got into the fall, things got colder, and people in the Northeast and Midwest started to go inside because it was getting cool outside. You saw those numbers start to go up as well. So it does seem to make sense that people in the Northeast need to take special care as we move into the fall.
So and how are Americans reacting now, do you think, to both the CDC and to President Biden's change in messaging?
I think there's a lot of confusion, and a lot of the confusion is warranted. Now, the disease is confusing, and obviously the Delta variant poses a new and significant threat. But by the same calculation, the guidance that was provided to the vaccinated Americans that they would not have to wear masks was actually a useful piece of information coming to the federal government. Some people thought it was coming actually too late. And what we've heard from some elected officials on the Republican side is that it's this kind of mixed messaging that that might discourage vaccinations. If people don't see that as a ticket to freedom. That said, the breakthrough infections are a new twist, and to see